I'm Adam Spate, the computing editor here at Trust Reviews, and I've got one of the most exciting PCs of the year in a review. It's the HP Spectre Fold. Let's unbox it. Right, so we've got the HP Spectre Fold here. It's another foldable laptop. We haven't had that many of these on the market yet. Let's get into unboxing it. I've just got some little tabs here. Just take these off. Yeah, so like I say, it's one of few foldable laptops on the market. We've had one from Asus. Lenovo is on to its second generation one, but this one looks particularly exciting because it just looks a bit more refined. I got the chance to see this at an HP event recently, but we've finally got one in a review. So this is just, yeah, your average quick start guide, because as we'll see, there's a few different elements to this. So I'll just pop that to one side and get the device itself out. I'll actually put the device to one side for a second as I get into the actual box itself and see what I've got. So we'll start with the basic stuff. So yeah, so right here we've got just the charging cable. It's braided, which is always nice. And then we've got, this is the cable that's going to help with charging the keyboard, which we'll get at that because you might not actually need that much, but that's another feature that's specific to that device. So yeah, we'll just put that to one side. And so yeah, this is the keyboard. Yep, so I'll open this up. Careful not to rip it because it's just a bit of cardboard here. So yeah, just in case you haven't seen any of these foldable laptops before, since there's not many of them, there's a couple of different form factors, with the Lenovo one being a smaller one, the Asus being slightly bigger, but they tend to come with these extra components because the foldable aspect of the laptop is just a screen. So for example, this one, like the Asus and the Lenovo, comes with this extra keyboard case. Yeah, and then we've just put this to one side for a second before we get back onto that, because just got some literature or the pen, which is quite important. We'll touch on that in a second. A dongle, which I believe this laptop only has USB-C, so it's another thing that's quite handy to have. We've got an extra nib here just for the pen. Let's just get this box out the way. So yeah, back onto the pen. It is a touchscreen. Yeah, it's pretty straightforward pen. It's similar to with the HP Spectre X360. You get a pen like this as well. They've always been nice to hold, and yeah, I think I've had a bit of a go with this myself. We've actually got first impressions of this up on the site, and writing on with a foldable, it's like a plastic screen, so that can feel a bit funny, but we'll get into that more fully later. So this is the device itself. So yeah, it's quite large. It actually comes in at 17 inches when fully folded out. So let's get to opening it, see if I can do it neatly. It's just sort of covered in tissue paper, which does the job, I guess. Sort of the reason I comment on it being covered in tissue paper is because in terms of protection, you're going to want to be very careful with this device, as I haven't mentioned it yet, but it is a device that's going to cost you £5,000, just under, or $5,000. So that is a lot, but I think this is very much a device that is sort of a proof of concept. As you saw with like foldable devices from the likes of Samsung on the phone side, they started off very expensive. And this seems like, if you've seen the Asus or Lenovo models, I think you'll see immediately that this looks like a more refined bit of kit. So let's just turn it around and have a look at the display itself. And then, yes, so obviously the main element here, it's foldable. yeah, as you can see, there's another USB-C. Let's have a look. Another USB-C right there. Some volume controls, power, webcam shutter. But yes, back again to the main element we have here is the big screen. So you have, as well as, let's just get into the modes a bit quickly. So if you look on the back here, we've got this little stand. And again, I just want to point out the design, because with the devices like the Asus and the Lenovo, it's not as refined as this, whereas this actually looks like an HP Spectre laptop in foldable form. And then, so yeah, you've got this stand right here, which actually stand up, and you can imagine, yeah, we've got like, so then we've got the keyboard right here, and you can get typing away. So again, let's have a quick look at, so this just obviously, there's a lot of advertised modes for this. So then we've got stuff like this, just getting back into actually like using this device. We've got, so despite, again, it's got that high price, but it's a device largely intended for productivity. So like on board, it's gonna have an Intel Core i7 12th gen processor, which isn't the sort of the latest and greatest, but it should do, certainly do the job in terms of productivity. They've managed to cram a decent 94.3 watt hour battery in, so that's closing in on like the limit you want if you're going to be sort of traveling with a device like this. Just to get back to the actual specs of the display, it's so yeah, the 17 inches when folded out, when folded in half, and you can also, this attaches magnetically, and you get the keyboard and the trackpad, and that turns into a 12.3 inch display. So yeah, the screen itself is a OLED panel. It's has something which HP says it's IMAX enhanced certified PC, which means it matches certain standards, obviously using that moniker that you're familiar with like movies and things like that. Another interesting thing that, yeah, in my first impressions with this, you can also go for what HP is calling a 1.5 display mode, which you can put this at the end, and it's sort of got a neat little crease here, and it just sort of drops down, so you can use that comfortably, and you get that sort of second display effect. So yeah, and then let's bring the stylus back in. So yeah, so when it comes to the stylus, obviously expecting you can have this big large 17 inch canvas and do a bit of drawing. We'll get into seeing how that is in the full review. But yeah, just finishing off the sort of tour of this device again, like when it's closed, just to bring it up again with the Asus and the Lenovo and things like that, you can sort of tell the sort of a bit of a different device, a bit of a concept, whereas HP's clearly hold it off a bit, waited until the sort of got it right, and it just looks like your sort of average, well, not average, but HP Spectre laptop, and it's like remarkably compact. Before, again, yeah, you open it up. I referenced before regarding the keyboard and the cable for charging it. One thing when I was at the HP Imagine event recently, where they showed off a ton of new products, and this was one of them. I spoke to Josephine Tan, who's the general manager of the consumer business unit there, and she pointed out that an interesting feature that she was really eager to get in on this device was actually that it has wireless charging in the bottom half. So you can actually, whereas with the other devices, battery life was a bit of an issue, especially because this is a Bluetooth keyboard, using it separately, you're going to worry about that as well as the device battery life itself. Whereas with this one, it's got the wireless charging on the bottom, so it'll be charging this as you do it. The the stylus, as you can see, attaches magnetically. So yeah, that charges as well. So I think that's, this is quite a few neat sort of quality of life features. And obviously at £5,000, you're gonna expect HP to really nail it. But yeah, I think overall, and you, again, you can read my first impressions, look out for my full review. It's just a more refined bit of kit, and it's some ways goes to justify that high price. But again, the other one seemed a bit more concept. I had a way to go. This is HP's first try at this. And it just seems like, for the high price, there seems very little. It seems to have nailed the foldable formula quite early on, but I don't want to get ahead of myself, need to fully review this. But yeah, just one little last look. If you look, this huge foldable display that obviously is going to be great for multitasking, watching movies. Yeah, so 17 inches folded out, 12.3 inches when used. That was another thing I'll quickly touch on actually. So yeah, in on the other devices, felt like laptop mode wasn't necessarily as viable. It felt a bit clunky, whereas with this, again, a more refined experience. And that's, yeah, through this unboxing, I think you've just, let's close it up as well, actually. During my preview, they said it was actually sort of made, because there's a little gap when you don't have the keyboard in, there's a little gap there, and it's actually closed to like neatly fit inside, whereas some of the other devices don't fold up as neatly together. As you can see, this sort of folds up really nicely. That's my unboxing of the HP Spectre Fold. Be sure to check out my full review on site, which should be coming in a couple of weeks.